So let us begin with the first, which is financial abstraction. Is anyone here a big video game player? Okay, Xbox? Who, put your hands up if you're an Xbox player. Yeah, really? Okay, so this is my gamer tag, add me. I have no friends. For a while, I was playing this game called Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare, which is this multiplayer shooter, and you're basically a plant or you're a zombie and you're shooting. And the idea behind the game is that you're in this room with like 24, or this room, this like area with like 24 other people, and they're really, really, really good. And it's, you're supposed to have this chat system where you can hear otherwise. For the first like couple of months, the EA, the developer, that chat system was broken. And so I just thought, these guys are good, man. I'd get my little cactus out and I'd try to snipe, pea shooter would hit me right in the head, and I was getting like pissed off. Like, I get a little, I rage quit sometimes. And then, all of a sudden, one day, they turn the chat on. They're all 8 years old. They're all eight, and they're like, ha, I got the pea shooter! I'm like, are you kidding me? So I switched to more grown-up games. One of my favorite is this game called Watch Dogs. And Watch Dogs is a great game, hacker game. This is the first version of Watch Dogs, which I like better than the first one. One of the modes in Watch Dogs is this area where you go into free roam, and you basically just do whatever the hell you want with no consequence. It's you can throw bombs on things, and you know, you get cars in the game, but you basically, you're a hacker, so you just unlock them with your smartphone, you just steal the car. And so you get in this lobby with a bunch of people, and kids mostly, and you run up and you stand on top of their car and you get your little bazooka out and you're like, I'm gonna shoot your car, and they go for it, and it's fun. I'm 46 years old. But there's no consequence, right? There's no real consequence to this because it's not real money. And if your car gets blown up, you just go steal another car, or you buy another car with the in-game money or something like that. And this is one example of the financial abstraction that young people today are living with, right? They have become disconnected from real money and the role of real money. And in a moment, we'll see how that affects payment, which it does in some pretty drastic ways. This financial abstraction in video game carries through for most video games, but not all. And the one exception is GTA 5. I keep looking for my video game friend now for validation. GTA 5, which you will notice looks a lot like Watch Dogs, but has a slight difference. So this is, you know, playing a game, and I'm just doing my regular mayhem again in a group of a whole bunch of people, and I start throwing these bombs on cars, and this little kid runs up to me in his character, because you can hear them all, and says, please don't blow up my car. Well, not only did I blow it up, I also, it was such an explosion that the fire department apparently showed up. So I blew up his car. And the kid burst into tears. And then his mom came on the headset. I recorded that. I'm now going to play you. No, I didn't record it. I'm just kidding. Boy, everyone's on the edge of their seats there, though, aren't they? They're like, I can't wait to hear this shit. You're all sick people. But he was absolutely distraught because unlike Watch Dogs and unlike a lot of other video games, in fact, most video games, there is a real cost to this. It's not that you necessarily have to play with real money, but when you see a car in GTA 5, you can just go steal one, or you can buy yourself a nicer one. Now, there's two ways to earn money in this financially abstract world. The first is to play it in-game, right? You're always just sort of playing the game. You're doing missions. You get a mission. You kill some people. It's worth $80 or something like that. But it takes a lot. It takes a lot to get there. The other way, of course, as I'm sure we all know, is paying with real money. And so you go to EA, and you buy a card. A card with 1.2 million in-game dollars costs $25 in real money. I added up how much money I spent on Plants vs. Zombies after I paid for the game. It was $212. I'm not proud of that. So this kid either, this poor kid whose car I blew up, and there's no undo, there's no like restore save, his car was gone. So he either paid with his actual allowance. Shut up, I didn't know. Okay, look, I came from Watch Dogs. What do you want from me? There's no user manual. Or the alternative is he did it in game, which is great, right? I calculated how many hours it would have taken him to have earned that that car in game, and it was 82 hours. But it was his fault, really, because he had failed to buy insurance for his car, which is something you should do in case dicks like me show up in your game. This is actually true. One of the things that you could do, because he started to cry and he's like, I didn't have insurance for it. I'm like, what are you talking about? In the game, you can buy insurance in case dicks like me show up or you wreck your car, right? So there's a little bit more, there's a little less abstraction here, but for the most part, the young people today are playing without, and not just playing, but also using devices without a clear sense of the direct connection to money. That impacts payment and commerce in amazing ways. We see this every week in the news, don't we? You know, kids are buying in-game currency without understanding that it's real money that they're dealing with. Those lines are more than blurred now. They're practically invisible. And some brands are exploiting this. Disney invested $1 billion in what they call the magical wristband. It's your hotel key. It's your park pass. But most importantly, it's your wallet, because it's connected directly to your credit card. And I should tell you, this kind of experimentation with payment is not just a flight of fancy. It is built into the ethos of Disney, of that corporation.